Okay, if not, we can, are we ready to go to the next segment? Who's our, who's official? Or somebody say something. David, where's David? Help me. Okay. You know, they thought I'd be going away, I guess. Okay, wait, I heard somebody say I have a question. Okay, turn this wireless handheld up. Stand up because you're talking to the whole community, naturally. Turn that. Well, they're not here. No, nobody's home. I'm in charge. Al Hag, General Hag, I'm in charge now. Here.
Yes. You're doing a good job. A while back, I had read that they were going to start radiating meat. Have they started that? And as far as the labeling, what's required of that labeling?
They have approved the irradiation of meat and a few other commodities, like strawberries. There are very few marketers that have the guts to do that because they know that we generally don't. There is a symbol called a RADA symbol that is required. The industry is trying to get that removed. They want to try to change the nomenclature. They want to change our vernacular. They want us to call irradiation, quote, cold pasteurization. So it's legal in the marketplace. There's a grocery chain based in the east of Pennsylvania and New York called Wegmans. They have ground beef that's irradiated. They advertise it. You know, I for one would be happy if the Wisconsin legislature passed a law permitting raw milk sales with a warning sign, warning, not pasteurized. That would help me find maybe a product I might want to buy. So I don't think there's anything wrong with warning labels and irradiation that's really helping us. So there are some real concerns with changing the molecular structure of the food when it's irradiated, creating free radicals, creating carcinogenic compounds like benzene after irradiation. So don't look for that label. Or if you find it, don't buy it.
So the other question is, along the same lines, what is the purpose of irradiation? Is it kind of like this grade A license where you kind of have to funnel all the money through this one provider so that they can license it and utilize it?
Yeah, well, so I will quote the president of the Canadian Farmers Union. I forget his name, I'm kind of paraphrasing, it's not a perfect quote. He said, you know, I don't really, I don't care if it's irradiated, pasteurized, heated, or fricasseed. I don't want shit in my food. And so, I wish I could take credit for that. You know, the whole deal about irradiation is they want us to eat shit. And, you know, I don't drink pasteurized milk, and I don't get sick because there isn't fecal material in there, because my farmers are careful. And, you know, it's possible, we're dealing in nature, so we can't have fecal organisms in our food. The difference between the organisms that might make us sick for a day or two and a little uncomfortable, and the organisms that kill us, is industrialized livestock production. Because we've known for a long time how to prevent these deadly strains of E. coli in our food and in our own guts that kill us. And if you feed ruminants, cows and sheep and goats, in feedlots, a high concentration of grain, usually corn, it changes the rumen, the pH of the rumen in their multiple stomachs and creates a hospitable environment for these pathogens. We've known that even if you take them in the feedlot and you feed them hay for just a few days or a week, that it will clean out their intestines and make them healthier. That costs money. It's cheaper to irradiate our food, and that's what they'd like us to do. Any other questions before I hand this over? Wait.
What about the farm bill? What's the latest?
What about the farm bill? I was just in Washington 2 weeks ago when the farm bill came out. And the stench was just terrible. It's so complicated, I can't.